Hi everybody, it's Carole. Today I'm gonna do a flower dip, reverse dip. I'm gonna try something different. I'm gonna pour kind of like a bottom bottle pour, but these are the tops to Tylenol bottle, and I think this is like an Advil bottle. So I'm gonna pour the paint on those and see what we get. So I'm just spreading out my white Artist Loft paint and Floetrol. Just making sure there's enough on there. I don't want it too thin. So that I don't want to see the canvas, so because when I put the plastic on to pull to dip, there has to be some white paint left. I'll do the sides later. All right, that's my white. So I think I might do three. So I'll put one here. I've got DecoArt paint metallics today. I'm going to use some metallics. So I've got berry, I've got amethyst, and I have some folk art metallic. This is peridot green and a antique gold metallic. All right, so let's start with the amethyst. I just mix this with a bit of Floetrol and water. So a little goober in there. I just hope I made enough. I usually have to do this pretty slow. Oops. This This one I'll do the pink first. Just don't pour it on fast. Just let it go down slowly, or it'll go over the, you want it to go in the creases of the lid. So it makes the petals better. Now I'll put some of this on here. Whoops, don't go there. I'll do the purple here too. All right. I'll do the gold. Now this, I used some of the this metallic gold, and then I added some of my own of the basics gold to it, just to make it a little lighter. I think that's enough. I think that might be enough. Let's push some of this paint. This doesn't have much left on it. So I'm going to take this one off. That one is more rounded on the top, so it flows off easier. This is flat, so you kind of have to give it a little push. And take this one off. Now, I think I'll clean this one off and I'll just try it there. Don't make this paint too thin, because when you put the plastic on, it'll just won't hold its shape as much. I just have it to the normal consistency where it makes a mound and then disappears quickly. Or pours off like honey. I'm going to put some pink dots here. right. Some gold on here and then I'm done pretty much. Okay, so I'm gonna make some, actually I'm gonna put some gold in the middle here. Oh, that's a lot. Okay, I'm gonna take this one off. Oops, suction. Put some more of the berry in here. Some gold in here. All right, let's try these. Colors are pretty, I like them. Oh, they'll probably mush into one another. I've got some green metallic. Okay, let's do this. One corner at a time. Oh, I don't think this is going to work because where's the middle? I never thought of this before. I might have to pull it up before I get to the middle. Oh, there's a big bubble under there. This might turn into one flower. Cells. Whoa. Oh, trying to make three flowers, I ended up with one. Those are awesome. I really like it. I love the color. Oh, colors are awesome. I want to put my finger in here. I think it's awesome. I love it. I'm gonna leave it. I thought maybe I would try to get the more purple in there, but maybe it'll move a bit. There. Very cool. Let me hold this up for you. This was a long one, I'm sorry, but hey, you can't rush art. There you go. I'm not sure what kind of flower you would call this, but a flag. I don't know. What's the other word for a flag flower? Iris, maybe. All right. Well, thanks for coming by. And have a great day. Check out my other videos. Subscribe. Hit the bell for more, for a notification when I do more. And come back soon to my art room. I'll put the dried results at the end. Bye. Hi, everybody. Here's my dried results. Dried pretty nice. Some little cells on the ends of these petals. Oh, I really like this one. All right. There you go. Dried results. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.